Hi everyone, this is gonna be a pick a card reading with Menchiate Etruria deck. This is Menchiate Etruria deck, and I'm gonna use the technique described in the booklet of this deck. Now, to participate in this pick a card reading, yes, this is a pick a card reading or pick a deck reading, and in this reading, we're gonna use four different court cards or face cards, like you can see here. The King of Wands, Queen of Pentacles, King of Cups, Queen of Swords. It doesn't matter the gender, which gender they are. What matters is the suit, okay? And they are four suits representing one of the suit. Now, King of Wands will represent work. So choose this card if you want to know about your work. Queen of Pentacles is going to represent money, so pick this card if you want to know about your money. King of Cups is going to represent feelings. Pick this card if you want to know about your love life. And Queen of Swords is going to represent something abstract, so you can imagine, I don't know, anything religious, anything that doesn't belong to any of these three categories. You can choose this card if you want to know about something abstract. Now, what is exactly abstract? It's up to you to decide. You can just add anything you want in this card to know about. Now, we have these cards here. We have the Virtues, Elements, Zodiac Signs. We have the Major Arcana and the Minor Arcana. And we're going to use all of these cards to do this reading. So I'm going to shuffle up and distribute these cards, and then please think about what do you want to know about work, money, feelings, or something abstract. So I'm gonna shuffle up the virtues. I'm gonna give one virtue per court card. And yes, I think they can be reversed as well. All major arcana in this deck can be read reversed, but minor arcana cannot be read reversed, and also the court cards cannot be read reversed. So the virtues will tell us qualities that can be useful for you in achieving your goal. Now, elements, we're gonna shuffle them. Elements will tell you what kind of attitude you must assume in order to achieve your goal or for the wish to fulfill. Now, Zodiac represents the influences of environment. How do other people, situations, your environment influence and affect your situation? All are reversed. Okay. Now we're gonna draw three major arcanas for each of these questions. And each card will represent past, present, or future. Oops. Past, present, future, past, present, future. They're a bit hard to shuffle, these cards. Past, present, future. and past, present, future. And lastly, we are gonna use the pip cards. As you can see, they do not have reversals in Menchati deck, and they're more like just will tell how the positive or negative the situation is. That's all, nothing else. They don't have reversals, so I don't know why I'm shuffling like it's supposed to be for reversals. So again, I have to pull three cards. 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. The last one. 1, 2, and 3. Okay. Now, I hope I will not get confused with all these cards that look so similar, but I'll do my best. So, if you'd like to participate, please think again about which of these do you want to know, or maybe all of them, and choose one pile. Work, money, feelings, or something abstract. You can insert anything you want in something abstract. It can be religion, spirituality, war, peace, happiness, studies, anything. And we'll start this reading. Have you chosen? So let's start with work. If you choose work, first we're gonna look at our virtues, and the virtues will tell us what quality of yours can be useful in achieving those goals in this particular situation or in this particular, you know, when trying to achieve goals at work. So we have charity reversed. So already for me, it seems that charity reverses don't be so charitable. Perhaps it talks about not wasting money, you know, being good, better with money, you know, and don't be so, let's say, wasteful in the situations. Maybe you're very kind and generous, and people tend to take advantage of you. So the card is reversed, the charity card is reversed. So actually it advises not sharing that much, and not giving everything away. For example, maybe you naturally just want to give everything away to others. You just, if you're undercharge, for example, if you're offering a service, you might undercharge, or you might be afraid to ask for money. Maybe there are issues. Maybe you're too lean, too good to your partners, don't fight for yourself that much, you know, financially. So it says maybe it could be better not to give away so much, you know, and a little bit to stop, you know, being that generous person, because it's bad for your finances, it's bad for your work. So too much charity might be a bad thing. Now, next we'll look at the element, and the element will tell you what attitude you must assume in this particular work, in your work life, basically. So we have earth reversed. Again, we talk about materialistic processes, materialistic things. The earth is usually being grounded, and being too material, too grounded actually, and very practical and intelligent. But actually it's reversed. Earth is reversed, so it's telling you that you're too practical, you're too maybe pessimistic when it comes to your work, and you think that there's no any possibilities in the future. But the reversed earth talks about fantasizing on inexistent possibilities, letting oneself get carried away by enthusiasm. So I think in this case, I kind of feel that you have to you know, fantasize. You have to be enthusiastic. In your case, maybe you do too less of that. So maybe you have to dream about what kind of possibilities are there, and maybe think of any creative ways that you can go further, you know, in your work. So for you, some fantasy will be useful. The next card is a zodiac sign, and it will tell you the attitude that you must assume in order to succeed. Oh, sorry, the zodiac will tell about environmental influences. Environmental, how does environment affect you, the people around you, where you live, you know, the situations that are happening. We have the Libra reversed. So Libra reversed is actually maybe you're bombarded with too many choices, too many opportunities, and maybe you're surrounded by people who are judgmental, and you might be afraid to actually make a decision or afraid to move forward because of what will these people say. So Libra reversed, you know, it's indecision. It's being dependent on the judgment of others, fear of being judged. So I think it's pretty negative influence coming. So you have big challenge, you know, to overcome. The next three cards is Major Arcana cards. And they are talking about past, present, and future. How did your actions in the past, how did they lead you to the present moment? What is happening in the present moment, and what is most likely to happen in the future? So in the past, we have the basically Hierophant reversed. In the present, we have the Hangman. And in the future, we have Strength. So all these great cards. Okay, so looking in the past, we have this reversed Hierophant. Now, it does tell about some not very wise decisions, let's say, some mistakes and errors, maybe hypocrisy here and there. Maybe you were faced by hypocrisy of others. Maybe you were not 100% honest yourself. Maybe try to pretend who you're not, or promise what you cannot do, or feel like you're a hypocrite, or maybe you face a system that was hypocritical, you know, in the past. So some sort of maybe there was a mistake or error to learn from in the past. And currently we have the Hangman, which talks about actually being very wise and being able to very spiritually view the current situation, and without compromising your values, somehow stay in the situation and maneuver through it without betraying yourself, without betraying your values. So it's like standing up for yourself, like you're looking for that meaning at work, that ethical, you know, way of dealing with things, and the way that is honest to you, where you do not basically, where you stay faithful to yourself and you do not betray your moral values. So it's very important if we actually compromise our values at work. I think we can never be happy with that work. So the Hangman reversed, or not reversed, it's just Hangman, yeah, right? It says that you're doing very well with that. You'd rather lose the money, you'd rather let it stop. Let the work stop. You'd rather be unemployed, you'd rather be bullied by people, but you believe in your spiritual values and that you have to stand by them, and you're doing that, which is great. Now in the future, we actually have improvement. We have the Strength card. That means that in the future you will be able to take things in your in your hands, and you will be able evaluate the situations logically. You will not be let into any, you know, intuitive or instinctual type of judgment. You will be very practical and logical and rational. And I think you will be able to see the situation the way it is and to deal with it in the best and the most intelligent way. So I think that's pretty good. And the last three cards is actually the pip cards, and we will not read the particular meanings, although we can read the meanings of them. And basically they will tell us, you know, how positive or negative the situation overall is. Okay, so let's have a look at our how positive or negative situation is. So let's have a look. So we have 10 of cups. Doesn't matter that they are reversed, we're not reading reversals. Cups mean positive situations. Now we have wands mean problematic situations, and we have pentacles, which means happy situations. Now the suits are very varied here. We don't have like all cups or all wands or even two suits, we have three suits. That means that it's quite confusing and up and down roller coaster type of situation emotionally. And sometimes it can be positive, sometimes it can be negative. It's like a wave, like up and down. Now we have two positive suits and one negative suit. That means that positivity wins over this. And basically it means that it will overall is a positive situation. There'll be some problems, but you will overcome those problems and you will be happy. We don't need to go into depth and read the meanings of each and every, you know, suit in each and every card, but I can do that. For example, the 10 of cups will represent being happy with work, being happy overall with your life and family and work and the whole vibe. You know, with the staves, we will have a situation where you will be too perfectionist in solving those things or keeping everything together, you know, or being too, not wanting to spoil things. You'll be just too, working too hard with everything. And the coins, the four of coins, will mean overall being, you know, wanting to keep the situation, not wanting to lose the situation, wanting to keep to the people that are involved in the situation, and basically looking for that happiness, looking for that positive outcome and working towards it. So you can take that credit, I think, for being the person who's looking to solve this, who's looking to somehow maneuver this and win, you know, and have that happy outcome. So I think it's quite a nice reading. It says that there are problems, especially they were maybe in the past, and the main idea was hypocrisy to yourself. Somewhere you try to compromise something, we're not honest with yourself. Perhaps you might not be, some maybe overspending is happening, oversharing is happening, and lack of dreaming, you know. So these things can be fixed, and in the future we have a good outcome. Okay, I hope this made sense for you and your work. Let's move to money now. Whoever chose the money pile, let's have a look about the money. Let's have a look about at the money, about the money. So if you chose the money, the first card is the virtue suit, and it will tell you what quality of yours could be useful in gaining more money or taking care of money. And we have the card of prudence. Well, it goes without saying, prudence is wisdom, and you need a lot of wisdom to take care of that money. So I think it makes sense. So no wastage again. Taking care of money, being financially aware, being very careful with money, following your, you know, expenditures, collecting your receipts, you know, seeing where the money goes, you know, that sort of thing. So being prudent with money, that would be really helpful for you. Now, next card is the element, and it will tell us what attitude you must assume to get to your money goals that you want to get. We have the fire. Well, fire, as you can see, you have to be passionate, you have to be active, and you have to kind of be to act when you need to act, okay, and not to miss up. Basically, I'm talking about missed opportunities, you know, and the delays that you can actually burn the opportunity while waiting. So it's basically fire means to become inflamed at the right moment and for the right reasons. So it's important not just to be passionate and inflamed and active, but on the right time, at the right time, to act on the right time and for the right reasons. So maybe that's a subtle element with money. So maybe it can refer to investments or, you know, for example, these seductive deals where we want to spend money or we want to buy something like a property, or even on a smaller scale, we're attracted by these nice new tarot decks on Amazon, and they might be expensive, so maybe we think it's a one-time opportunity, but maybe it's not the right reason to be inflamed for about, you know, to buy that deck because it's so expensive and it's bad for overall money. So that sort of situation. The next card is the zodiac sign, and it will tell you how your environment influences you. That can be people, friends, family, also situations that are happening around you. And we have the Scorpio reversed. So not so good, okay? Scorpio reversed, it's not so good, but maybe it can be good actually, because Scorpio upright is not good. It's not good. So reverse Scorpio is basically being too jealous and cultivating these destructive behaviors and trying to scare people off with your power and being a bit mean, you know, because you're jealous and emotional and hurt, you know, so that sort of thing. So it's, I think Scorpio's weak point is their jealousy. And I think maybe you might look at other people getting the money that, you know, they're getting. And maybe it's not working for you as easily as for those people. So you might feel hurt, you know, hurt key, why I'm not having it. So this might make you passive aggressive or just like wish bad things to those people who got that money, like deep down inside, not like openly, because you understand it is bad. So that sort of jealousy and comparison maybe with others could be not a good thing. And maybe you end up living or being close to those people who have a lot of money. And it's like a paradox where, for example, everyone is just doing amazing around you and you're not, or not as much as them, and it's just made like that for you to overcome the jealousy, to practice overcoming the jealousy or envy, things like that. So this is just something to work with, nothing bad. Okay, the next three cards are actually the major arcana cards, and they will tell you about your past, present, and future, and about how these things affected your decisions. So decisions that affected you, motivations and decisions to get into the present moment, the wheel. Great. Now the wheel talks about, opportunity, chasing the opportunity. Many opportunities are happening, you know, and in your life. So let's see, many opportunities were there and you were able and you knew how to use those opportunities. So let's say you did pretty good in the past with money. Yeah, you took the right opportunities at the right time. So maybe you're already quite experienced in this. So, and maybe it has led you to where you are right now in a way. Okay, but of course, maybe you want to know how you can get more money. But you are not new in this. The present moment is the Fool card. Well, the Fool can talk about a feel that insecurity in a way. Of like starting something new and trusting your intuition a lot. Like right now, it seems like you're really feeling it. You're really letting your inner gut to guide you when it comes to money. It's not as much intellectual or research based, but it could be inner, you know, intuition. You know, where do you feel the money is? What do you think is the right decision to do? Like, it's based on the inner guidance. So it might be a good thing. It might be really careful, conscious conversation with your inner self. And you have if you have a good connection with your inner self, it will guide you where you need to be in the future. Great. We have the Death card. Death upright. So the Death card, we have some losses, unfortunately. We have some losses in the future with the Death card, financial losses. Now, financial losses can refer to expensive buys where you have to spend a lot of money on something you cannot help. It can be like some house renovation or some health issue or some risky, just a shopping spree, or I don't know, losing a job, or so it can be because of voluntary reasons, buying something and spending all your money, investing all that money somewhere, basically your account is empty, or having to lose it through some sort of other reasons. So that Fool card actually might show that maybe you letting intuition guide you might not be the best thing right now. Okay. I wish it offered some advice about how I think maybe that intuition thing. Advice. We have the Judgment card. How to avoid a death situation? How can we go better? Maybe judge well. Yeah, you have to really research. You have to really research everything. Don't let your intuition guide you, actually. It's maybe not good with money. And don't trust people you work with. You have to research and check all the people you're working with and the situations that you're in financially. Do not trust fake promises. Do not get into scams. Do not go by someone's word. You have to really, really deep check everything, okay? No risk taking, no intuition. Basically, that's what you're doing, but this might lead you to loss. So the Judgment says, double check everything, people, situations. You need facts. Okay, now we have the last three cards, and these are the pips, and we're gonna look in those pips overly whether the situation is positive or negative. We have Swords, they mean painful situations. We have Two Wands, that mean problematic situations. So it's still better. So we have Two Wands suits, which means that wands win. That means that from painful situations, very bad situations, you'll go into problematic situations, which is a little bit better than before. But still, these three cards are still considered to be pretty negative, okay? We usually don't have to interpret each and every card, a pip card, in this particular technique, but we can, okay? So, Eight of Swords, it means lack of knowledge, an inability to perceive and understand the situation that's happening, and inability to, you know, to just understand the situation, to evaluate the situation because of lack of data or lack of some sort of just brain power or lack of something. So you're pretty confused what you're doing, what's happening. Yeah. There's no control over the situation, that sort of feeling. Now, the Six of Staves. And now it shows that the problems that you're facing, financial problems, is probably not yours alone. There probably are more people involved in those problems, and you're trying to take up the responsibility of those people and solve everything yourself, which is not good. That's not going to work. It's too much. And also the Five of Wands, it talks about fights and disagreements with other people. So it's very likely that other people will be kind of in the way to solve these financial problems, because they not only have those problems, but they're also not helping you to solve these problems. So they kind of the cause of the problem, and at the same time, they're not helping you to solve the problem, who's trying to solve things. So that sort of situation. So it's kind of explains a lot of things. It says that it's kind of maybe a group problem or a family problem, or there are more people involved, and that's why it's more difficult in that kind of situation. So yeah, this was our reading about money. I hope this was like helpful and a little bit accurate. Now, we're moving on to the feelings. We're moving to the feelings, and King of Cups represents those feelings here. As I mentioned, the gender doesn't matter in this particular case. I didn't want to upset any gender, so I've chose two queens and two kings. And yeah, King of Cups is feelings. Doesn't matter who's doing the reading, male or female. Okay, so first, we will open the Virtue card. And the Virtue card will tell us, in this particular love relationship or love problem, feelings is relationships, basically. It will tell us what quality of yours could be useful in this particular situation. And I picked it up like, did I pick it up like this? I don't remember how I picked it up. I picked it up like this. Really messed up. Was it like this or was it like this? Now I'm so not used to the reversals. If I was to pick up this. Okay, I think it was like this. I'll read both meanings. Okay, so have hope reversed. Hope reversed, that is the quality of yours that can be useful. And I think do not have high hopes when it comes to this relationship, or high expectations, basically. Yeah, it's probably the advice as to giving up hope that situation could change. So basically lower the expectations. Maybe that's the biggest problem. Now, if I did a mistake, if it was like that, the hope card, it would mean be hopeful. Of course. So that sort of situation. Now it can be some sort of unrequited love or marriage with a particular person, or some old flame with whom everything is not perfect. So depending on situation, let's say I'll go with the reversed hope, which means do not hope for it. Maybe it's time to lose the hope. Okay, next card is the Element card. Attitude you must assume. How should you behave in this situation? And we have the Air reversed. Now with the Air reversed, well, we have so I think relaxing a little bit. Air reverses, relaxing a little bit. And relaxing the situation, relaxing the focus on the situation, letting it go a little bit and not being so focused on it, not being so stuck up with it, and actually being a little absent-minded and actually being a bit superficial and careless about it. I think that kind of attitude, when you kind of don't care. So that's how you should behave with this person in this situation. Zodiac sign will tell us, will tell you, how does your environment influence you? How do the people in that environment and situations influence you? Have the Cancer reversed, and the Cancer is super emotional, super sensitive, and I don't know whether the people around you are very sensitive and critical, or you feel very self-critical and sensitive around the people that you live with, for example. So maybe you feel that every single situation makes you cry, or every single relative or friend around you just makes you cry, and it brings out your the most self-critical part of you when you're with them. So that might be Cancer reversed. So it's that sort of like a crybaby situation. Maybe other people also complaining and crying and remembering bad stuff. So it makes you depressed as well. And, you know, so that sort of situation is there. Now let's have a look at our major arcana cards. This represents past, present, and future. So what kind of actions in the past and motives led you to the present moment? We have the Hermit. Definitely could be being single for a long time, not feeling lonely, you know, and maybe that's what led you to want, maybe feeling like you're about to get old, also being very, very careful and overthinking every relationship, maybe not initiating or not looking for a relationship. So you were so maybe super wise and super careful. Also can be all the other things that I mentioned, loneliness, being single, feeling of that I'm about to turn 50, or I'm about to turn 100, or I'm about to turn 30. You know, it can be that sort of like, and I need to find someone soon because I'm about to get old. You know, all these things, you know, with Hermit. It can be just feeling a bit blah, you know, even being young, but feeling like that. And also maybe avoiding relationships because relationships are not perfect. You know, relationships hurt. Relationships are like this. So because of that, that carefulness, that prudence, you might not have let in the people. You might not have let the people in. Current situation is star reversed. Now, star reversed in this particular deck, it's talking about the lost hope. Is it the reverse star? Yeah, it's like not very hopeful and optimistic about this relationship or relationship in general. You know, feeling like it's not gonna work out, I'm losing this person, this is not it, you know. So this card is like loss of hope, pessimism, that sort of situation. Well, maybe it's correct, because the advice is actually hope reversed. Unless I read it wrongly. If it's hope upright, then you can rewind in the video, and it means have the hope. It's not all lost, you know. So the future, we have the Justice. Well, Justice is kind of neutral card. It's a neutral card, more like saying that everything will be the way it has to be. The justice and balance will be there, and you will achieve that mental balance. Also, maybe you'll be able to think logically in the future about the situation, like very coldly, without emotion. And when you're in that frame of mind, things will not seem as painful. You know, maybe you'll realize the truth about the person that you're crushing, or the person that you're concerned about. Maybe you realize that they're not that good of a person after all, and you don't really want them. And you've been all suffering because of this person for no reason. You know, maybe they were not even the person worth worrying about or having a crush on. So it's like the veil of illusion will fall, and you will see the truth. And the truth is healing. Now, our last three cards, they are the PIP cards, and they generally are not interpreted in this particular method, but we can always interpret them if we want to. The book says we can do whatever we want to as well. So good suits mean positive things, and bad suits mean negative things. So in this case, Wands and Swords are negative suits, and Cups and Pentacles are positive suits. So in this case, we have two problematic suits. Wands are the problems, and one happy suit, which is Pentacles. So in this particular case, I think problems kind of overcome the happiness, and I would say there will be more like difficulties and problems rather than happiness. So to have it more clearly, the end will be with, like, it will end with a feeling of still it's not satisfying ending. It's not complete detachment from the situation. So to really get into the detail of this, we will have a look at the meanings, and yeah, so the Four of Staves, the Four of Wands, they talk about, let's say you had problems and you ignored them in the past. He had, there were issues that were ignored, maybe not directly relating to the relationship. Now the Nine of Wands, the Pentacles, they talk about actually being very lucky, you know, for some reason. Maybe the overall situation where this is happening, maybe the life itself is actually pretty lucky, you know, and happy, and everything is kind of fine. But again, we have those Nine of Wands, which is like sabotaging the happiness, the situation, making it more complicated than it is. And again, the meaning is trying too hard to solve these problems, to improve things that don't need improvement. So it's some sort of like maybe over-focusing on the situation, or, you know, like we people like to over-complicate things, or over-complicate. So that sort of situation. So now let's move on to our last pile, and it's about something abstract. Now this will be probably the most difficult to actually analyze. It can be anything. I said choose anything you want to know about in this particular pile, because abstract can mean, for me, I choose spirituality, I choose something psychological, I choose something that's not mentioned in here, which is not work, money, feelings. So it can be something about philosophical question, about life and death and truth and humanity and aliens and things like that. So it can be anything like that. So I'm just gonna pull the cards and you try to interpret whether they suit your situation or not and how they suit it. First, let's have a look at the virtues, and the virtues will tell what qualities of you can be useful in this particular situation. And we have the faith reversed. Do not believe in this. Faith is reversed. So maybe you're believing in something, or maybe this is based on a belief. Also, the advice is reverse, and it's like advice. So it says that you're good at pretending who you're not, like faking. And in this situation, it might be helpful to actually fake and pretend that you're someone who you're not, okay? If it's a philosophical question about belief, faith reverse means that it's a matter of belief or non-belief. So in this case, don't believe in it. The next card is the element, and it will tell you what attitude you must assume in this situation. We have water. What attitude you must assume in this situation, and we have water. So it's being very peaceful in whatever that is, and sailing smoothly in a situation. Do not be aggressive, do not be pushy, and you have to find that way how to be peaceful in this situation. There should be no conflict. So that's sort of advice. The next card is a zodiac sign, and it tells you how does the environment influence you, the people in your environment, how, you know, the situations, everything, how does it influence you? We have Taurus reversed. Well, Taurus reversed, it can mean that they can make you super angry, drive you to the limit, so to say, because the people in the environment might be super old-fashioned, super conservative, and be absolutely against any change. So maybe it's your family, maybe it's your society, your country, or just where you right now live or work. Some stubbornness is there from everyone. So it's pretty hard, good challenge. The next are three cards, and they're gonna be the major arcana cards that will tell us about past, present, and future. Past is shows us what kind of motives and behaviors led you to the current situation. We have the moon. We have the moon card. And it's upright. So it means that maybe you visualized what you wanted. You had very clear understanding of what you wanted, and you were being very consistent with your ideas and your action, the plan of action, action plan, on how to get here, for example, or, you know, whatever the question is. So it's very good card. Now, what about the current situation? We have the Temperance card. Also, it's a very good card. It shows that you're balancing things well, that you're very friendly with people, that you're a non-conflicting person, and you're super diplomatic. Basically, you're very good at avoiding that conflict. It says avoid the conflict, be the peacemaker, and it seems that you're already the peacemaker. You know how to maneuver all that. What is the future? We have the world. Looks like an amazing card. Now, the world card, usually it's achievement of goals and travel and getting what you want and getting a, you know, you know, the prize. And in this deck as well, the meaning is complete success. Just a talent to understand things, even in the midst of chaos, overcome that confusion and see things as they are and see the potential and, you know, the clarity in that and actually being successful with your goals. So it's an amazing card. Your wish will fulfill 100%. Now these cards will tell us the situation is positive or negative. Painful situations, happy situations, happy. So there was some pain in the beginning, but it all got solved into to be happy. We don't read reversals in the minor arcana, but we, and also we do not interpret each and every card. We just look at it's happy or not happy, and we see it's positive. So it's pretty good. But if you want, we can also interpret every single card. Now, Six of Swords will be... So let's say you got out to achieve this goal with lots of baggage from the past, which was negative and painful. So let's say you have a past. You had a past. So maybe that was your mistake in the past. Maybe that was the only negative in the situation. But Six of Coins. But then you decided to help people. Maybe it's a business or something. Maybe it's some sort of like you decided to share with people. But while you shared with people, you thought about your own good as well. Like, what will you get back from that sharing? So it was kind of like mini investment or like a sale or some sort of like strategy. Maybe you shared your pain. Maybe you found an opportunity to kind of sell something. And in the future, it says, or, you know, you will accumulate wealth. So, you know, accumulate wealth, but with your own hands independently. So, you know, it can be for me, it looks like therapy or like sharing things with others that are negative. So you relieve yourself of that pain while also earning the money, something like that. Or basically, this detailed interpretation might not work. So, and the method actually just suggests us to interpret the suits, which is happy suits and positivity. So this is very happy reading. All readings are pretty good. Yeah. So I hope that you enjoyed the Mincha Atithurya reading as it is described in the booklet of Mincha Atithurya. Yeah, very fun to do. Something new, I think, something a bit unique, because I've tried it and it worked for me. It answered my questions, but I'm a bit lazy to divide the deck into so many parts and then, you know, reshuffle everything and then select a significator. And there's a lot of steps, I think, which is a bit antique way of reading, which makes it exotic and kind of fun. So thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you again next time. If you want to request a topic or a video, please request something that many people might like, or not like very, very personal. You can do that on my email, eaglecards123@gmail.com. Thank you and bye-bye.